Okay, now that we have built some lists, let's now look at how to insert and build a table. I took out two of the lists and just left our description list here, and we're going to put a table below this header that says video. So let's go in our HTML and see what that looks like. I'm going to go ahead and put it in this section here. I created a section with a header H3 of videos. And to start our table, we're going to do a table within brackets. And within our table, our first tag will be thead, which represents table head. And so this is that top row of our table. We do a tr for table row, and then we're going to open that up. And then we do th. Now this is the cell content. The h, again, is for the header. It's acknowledging that this row, these cells, are header cells. And then this is where we would want to put the title of that column, the top row. So for me, I'm going to put title, and then I want to have two columns, so I'm going to do one more th, and this one is going to be description. Perfect. Now that we've gotten our head taken care of, now let's work on the body of our table. So that would be t body, and within the body we once again use the tr to represent the first row of the body, and then each cell this time will be a TD instead of TH. And then for this one, this would actually be a title of the video, so we could say this one, inserting a table using HTML and CSS. And styling, can't forget the styling. Inserting and styling a table using HTML and CSS, there we go. And then for the next one, this would be the description of the videos. In this video, we review how to build a table and style it using HTML and CSS. Okay, perfect. Very important here. Notice that we have two THs and two TDs. For each table row, we want to have equal cells or table data. That's what the D stands for down here. If I have two up here and one down here, first of all, Aptana will yell at me and will give me a caution sign. And if we loaded it, it would look all warped because there needs to be equal cells for each row. And there we go. We have a nice little table here, just two rows with two columns. Now let's go ahead and apply some styles. I'm going to scroll up to the styles here. First going to our, you guessed it, preset styles. And we're going to add quite a few things. Our list is getting fairly long. We're going to add table, TD, TR, TBody, THead. Oh, and I almost forgot the TH. Let's put the TH in there. Perfect. And then we're going to go down here and create a new section. I'm going to stick it below that new section that we made for the lists. And we're going to call this one main table. That's good enough. Main table, website table. This is just for your eyes only. Oh, I forgot my spaces. Silly me. And then for our styling rule, we're going to go ahead and do TD and TH, which means we're styling our cells. And our declaration is going to be border. We're going to want a border of 1 pixel space, no comma, solid black. First, it's the thickness of the border and then the color. And then let's do font size. Let's try 1.3 m's. And then let's add some padding, otherwise it will look really crowded in there. Let's do a 0.4 m. Not too much, not too little, just right. And then text, align, center it. And then let's add another rule below that one. Let's go table. And let's do width 100%. What this will do is it will take the table and stretch it, but it will never make it too big to where it's bigger than the screen they're using, which is nice. And then let's do a border around the table. This is around the table versus just around the cells individually. And let's do 2 pixels this time, a little thicker, and then let's try purple this time for the heck of it. You know what? Let's just add one more style rule. I'm going to style the TH, and I know what you're thinking. You're like, Melody, you already have the TD and the TH up here, but I want the head row or the header to be a different color than the rest of my cells, which means the style can only apply to the TH cells. And let's try a background color of #3F16694. That's that purple color that we were using for our footer. And then color, I'm going to actually have the font be white because otherwise it's going to be hard to see. Okay, now hold up, folks. That's not it. We did apply some styles to our table here, but okay, let me first show you what it looks like so far. I know you're just eager to see it. We saved it. Now let's go in and refresh. Scroll down here Okay, so right off the bat, you see the issue I wanted to address. Okay, so notice when you look at the table, there's this gap in between here. Well, we can fix that. By default, it has the small gap between the individual cells. So to take care of that, let's jump back in our HTML, and let's go back up to our reset values. And let's add a new declaration just for table, and let's tell it to border collapse. Collapse. I know it sounds redundant, but that's the way it goes. And that will get rid of that space that we see. And then let's do border spacing 0. And that will get rid of that gap that we're seeing in between the cells. And refresh it and see how that works. Scroll down. Much better. See, now it looks like a table. Now, I don't like not only how close this video's header is to the table itself, it's also smaller than the table, so that doesn't look too enticing. But if we jump into our CSS, you'll see why. In our CSS, in our header section, we look here, we haven't styled an H3 yet. So this heading right here is just a default taking up from our reset styles. Let's style that header. I'm going to grab this one here, and that's because the background color of the H1 is purple with white. That would look really funky. So I need a separate declaration for the H3. And so I'm going to change this to H3. I'm going to take out that background color and font color of white. And then the font weight, the size, that's fine. The text shadow, that's a little too big. Let me try 1:1, so it's barely there. And then, so it's a little bit more subtle, let's make it gray instead of black. And then height, that's gonna be pretty far above the table, so let's reduce that, let's try 50. Okay, so let's save these styles to our heading. Go back in here, refresh. Oh, much better. Look at how much better that looks. So this would be a list of my YouTube videos, the title of the video, and the description of the video. And we have our table. How great does that look? Now, if we wanted to change the background color of these cells, remember we changed the background color of the TH, that's easy enough to do. If we go down here and find where we did the TH in our main table area, we can add another one for TD. And a background color of, what color do we do? Well, remember, when in doubt, look at an HTML color chart or color picker. So if we just go HTML color codes, that works too. And then we'll just go to one of these sites. And I think I'm gonna go with maybe like a light violet, like one of these colors. Let's give this a try. Just grab this code here, jump back in our code, and paste it. See how easy it is? Oh, so many colors at your fingertips. And then for the font color, we'll just leave that as black. So let's just stick with the color. Save it, and then go back into your site and refresh. And there we go. Just a subtle difference there, a little darker, but I think it looks great. If we wanted to make our border thicker, we can change that one pixel to a different color. We can change the border colors, but you get the point. That's how you make a table. Now, before we end this video, I want to talk to you a little bit about tables. There are some challenges in using them. Screen readers have a tough time conveying the relationship between the table elements and other elements on your page. When read using a screen reader, it may not read it in the order you're intending. Please be sure to only use tables when a grid layout like this is needed. And that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I will catch you in the next one when we start talking about responsive design. Enjoy your day. Don't forget to subscribe, and I will catch you later.